tell you something, Linda. You keep sticking your nose in Luger's business. You buddy, you're gonna...
Down it goes! Windham is wasting no time! He and Harley Race are going at it! But he cannot take on two men here, Mac!
One attack after another. When is this gonna stop?
This is Worldwide Wrestling. Tony Schiavone and Magnum TA and your ringside with the superstars of World Championship Wrestling. You saw at the top of the program how we ended last week. And I mean, it's hot and heavy when you talk about Barry Windham, Ron Simmons, and the world champion Lex Luger.
To say Race and Hughes are throwing their weight around would have to be the understatement of the decade, because they have definitely got the attention of Barry Windham and Ron Simmons.
They'll get a chance to throw their weight around this week as we will see the world champion for the first time ever in singles competition, as well as my chance to interview the world champion in the ring.
Luger's got the attitude, he's got all the right moves, and he's more dangerous than anybody could have ever imagined.
Our feature matchup this week will be Cactus Jack. We've talked so much about him. Gordon Solie will talk more about him on the Wrestling News Network. He'll be going up against Beatable Bobby one-on-one.
The high-flying Eaton, what he'll do to neutralize the attack of Cactus Jack, that's something I want to see for myself.
It's going to be a very interesting matchup. Beatable Bobby and Cactus Jack a little bit later on, but right now, fans, it's time to wrap.
Ladies and gentlemen, this contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Motown, he weighs 403 pounds, the Rutmaster, P.N. News.
Big Bad and Orange and P.N. News, the Rutmaster, has the ring. Here we go.
The posse's yelling ho, cause they know I'll steal this show and burn this house to the ground. Rock the beat and hit the sound. Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo. I said, yo, baby, yo, baby, yo. What's up, Albany?
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent from Palm Beach, Florida, 262 pounds, Mike Fever.
The Ratmaster PN News as we begin another hour here on Worldwide against Mike Fever. The Ratmaster, 403 pounds. Of course, he rules the ring with a rap, but of course, he has also been a very successful athlete in WCW. And I think that's why he uses his weight to his advantage.
Tony, you have to be an athlete to move 403 pounds around doing anything, much less the high-flying maneuvers, that big splash off the top, the record breaker. But this guy has got the agility of a lightweight and all that weight behind it.
He gets it moving the right way, and it's usually the wrong way for Mike Fever. And a good case in point there, he had his momentum going towards Fever. He put the brakes on and was able to put him face first.
You talk about being able to pivot and turn it on a dime, he can definitely do it.
The Ratmaster PN News calling out to the fans, and I mean, we have a tremendous crowd on hand here for Worldwide Wrestling this week. Glad to have you with us, just the beginning of our hour. You talk about agility, there it is, the drop kick, 403 pounds, getting horizontal in the air.
When we talk about strength, men, to get 403 pounds up in the air and execute a drop kick takes a tremendous amount of leg strength, much less time, and this really is a tremendous athlete, despite all the things that a few people are saying about his size.
Now, setting Mike Fever. Fever has had no offense whatsoever. A lot of power in those arms. PN News, the Ratmaster, after the belly-to-belly suplex, picking up Fever. He's going to place him exactly where he wants him, and he's ready to go up top, and the fans responding already.
Fever's got to be horrified.
PN News.
It's called the broken record, and it certainly breaks anyone in the ring with him. Let's listen as we look.
When the shoulders go down, one, two, three, the ones left standing on my posse and me. Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo! Yo, baby, yo, baby, yo.
Welcome to the WNN. I'm Gordon Solie. A little bit later on in this report, we'll bring you more information about Halloween Havoc 91, upcoming on Sunday, October 27th, exclusively on pay-per-view. But right now, the thrust of our story today has to be the situation regarding Sting and the mysterious large boxes that have been appearing at ringside. If you remember in St. Joe, Missouri, it was Abdullah the Butcher who suddenly sprang from the box and attacked Sting. And then Cactus Jack appeared at the Clash. And Sting appeared out of a box at the Clash. And then finally in Gainesville, a young lady came out. Now, what exactly is going on here? And who's behind setting up these boxes, obviously set out to destroy Sting's wrestling career? Well, we're going to take a moment right now to relive those moments as these mysterious boxes appeared at ringside and the results thereafter.
Wait a second! That's Abdullah the Butcher! Coming right out of the box!
Here's your winner, Sting!
Cactus Jack had appeared from the box. The box had been at ringside.
Oh, she looks like a real killer to me, man!
Well, the question remains unanswered. Who is behind the mysterious appearance of these large boxes at ringside? We know one thing. Somebody has to be paying a lot of money because Abdullah the Butcher and Cactus Jack are mercenaries. No question about that. Now let's turn to the Z-Man, Tom Zenk. As you know, he recently applied for a referee's license, and he has achieved that goal. And I might just also point out that he suffered some brutality that we're going to be seeing later on in this program. But the Z-Man is a gentleman of eminent fair play. He believes in calling it down the middle. But he has some goals now. He wants to make sure that men like Lex Luger and others of his ilk do toe the line when they step inside the square circle to compete, whether defending their titles or not. I have to admire the Z-Man for his courage in going after a referee's license. The Z-Man had these comments about his license.
It's been about a week now. Luger, the whole world's been talking. Who was it? I know who it was. Curtis Hughes, Harley Race. Luger, you sent your men after me to keep me down. You kicked me around the locker room. You know, my ribs are still sore. And you know something? I'm signed up to referee the one match. And I'm signed up for one reason, for a fair outcome. Lex Luger, there is going to be a fair outcome to that match. You know, you guys didn't get the job done. You had me down, but I'm not out. I'm here, and I'm going to referee that match. And there's going to be a fair winner. And when this thing is over, it's all said and done. Harley Race, Lex Luger, and Curtis Hughes, I'm coming after you, because it's going to be payback time. And don't think for 1 minute I'm not going to take it to you. Because listen, for what you've done to me, try to take my living away from me, I'm going to get you.
Well, I, for one, think that the Z-Man himself will make a fine referee. He's got his work cut out for him, however, in Halloween Havoc on Sunday, October 27th. More about that in just a moment. Of course, as you know, the main event that night will be a 2-out-of-3-falls match for the World Championship, pitting Lex Luger against Ron Simmons. Cactus Jack goes up against the world's strongest man, Bill Kazmaier. And you will also be seeing the 8-man steel cage Chamber of Horrors match. More on that in just a moment. In addition, the World Television Championship goes on the line, stunning Steve Austin, defending his title against the challenge of the natural, Dustin Rhodes. In a World Tag Team title match, it will be the Enforcers against the Patriots. Van Hammer takes on Michael P.S. Hayes. PN News and Big Josh take on the Unknown Creatures. We'll find out who they are on the 27th. Beautiful Bobby wrestles Terrence Taylor. Johnny B. Bad faces Jimmy Jam Garvin, and the Z-Man will face the World Championship Wrestling Phantom. And nobody knows who he is or where he comes from, but we will find out on Sunday, October 27th. May I suggest that you call your cable operators now and order Halloween Havoc 91 for Sunday, October 27th. As you know, of course, Paulie Dangerously and Missy Hyatt are trying to find out more about the Chamber of Horrors matches, and perhaps later on we'll get a report back from them. That's WNN for this week.
Big following tag team event, it is a 4-1 fall. Introducing first, from Bad Street, USA, in Atlanta, Georgia, the greatest rock and roll band of all time, the Fabulous Freebirds. Their opponents, total combined weight, 456 pounds. First, from Honolulu, Hawaii, Chris Sullivan. Baltimore, Maryland, Jumpin' Joey Mags.
Michael Hayes, Jimmy Jam Garvin, the Freebirds. We saw last week right on this program, and the little situation. Losing my words there, Mag, but the little situation with the Enforcers, the World Tag Team Champions, and the Enforcers have a reply to what happened last week, and they are standing by right now.
You know, in regards to this challenge we had from the Freebirds, let me tell you two punks this. We're gonna have you as regarded as highly as the American Bald Eagle itself, because you two wrestlers have just placed yourself on the endangered species list. Jerks.
Well, Tony, I would have to say that the Freebirds know how to fight fire with fire. They know how to be the dirtiest players in the game. They can do whatever it takes, as we talked about the Enforcers doing whatever it takes. And I don't think the Enforcers are going to be able to turn their backs on the Freebirds, because the Freebirds would love nothing better than to unseat them and become the World Tag Team Champions themselves.
They have been the World Tag Team Champions, not on one, but two occasions. Michael Hayes, Jimmy Jam Garvin, they were World Tag Team Champions as recently as earlier this year. Head first to the turnbuckle. And of course, they are veterans. Jumpy Joey Maggs is a youngster. Michael Hayes loves the limelight, to be on center stage, so to speak. He wants Sullivan in there, and I think he's going to get his wish. Right now, they are having a good time. But against the Enforcers, they do realize, even though they're very jovial right now, that they'll be in a fight.
It looks like Hayes is taking care of all the business by himself. You notice Jimmy Jam hasn't even taken his jacket off. I don't know if he plans on getting involved in this match or not, but Hayes is certainly taking care of business. Joey Maggs doesn't have a chance at this point.
Full arm drag and twist, and Maggs with a great counter move. He went right to the eyes. Got a blow in, he's gonna bring in Sullivan. So Maggs, once he gets a little bit of momentum, is gonna tag out here. Double team, left, left. Both to a double DDT.
And he took his jacket off for it.
Here are your winners, the Fabulous Freebirds.
The very talented Freebirds with a tremendous win. It was two left hands, double DDT. The coat had come off, and that was all she wrote. The Freebirds get a win.
Tony, here we have another look. Jimmy Jam looking so good. The double DDT, double your devastation. This was all it took.
We take you now to our top 10. Here's a look at the World Championship Wrestling Top 10 Rankings and Singles Competition for the weekend of October 5th, 1991. In the number 10 spot, the Diamond Stud. He's preceded by the number 9 man in the top 10 this week, the Rapmaster PNUs. Johnny B. Bad is number 8 this week. Cactus Jack checks in at number 7. The number 6 man in the rankings, the Natural Dustin Rhodes, preceded by the number 5 man, the World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin. 7'7" Elegante checks in at number 4 this week. The number 3 man from Sweetwater, Texas, Barry Windham. All-American Ron Simmons holds steady at the number 2 spot this week. And the number 1 ranked contender, the current U.S. Heavyweight Champion, Sting. And of course, the WCW World Heavyweight Champion is the total package, Lex Luger. And that's a look at the top 10 rankings this week in World Championship Wrestling. Gordon Sully told us on the Wrestling News Network, we are all wondering what the Chamber of Horrors looks like. We do understand that World Championship Wrestling dispatched Paulie Dangerously and Missy Hyatt to find out exactly what this big chamber looked like. And I understand they ended up in Secaucus, New Jersey.
What kind of investigative reporting they're doing, we will soon find out, because I want to know what that Chamber of Horrors match is all about myself.
I guess maybe if anybody can find out, it would be Paulie along with Missy. Let's take a look at Paulie and Missy's big adventure.
What are we we doing here?
Missy, the Chamber of Horrors is being built right now in this very warehouse.
In New Jersey?
Well, where else would you build a Chamber of Horrors but in New Jersey, Missy? Right next to a toxic waste dump.
Alma, you know what? If your source, that Slim character, has told us wrong, you're going to be in trouble.
It sounds like my Uncle Moisha the Peeping Tom, and Uncle Moisha the Peeping Tom is never wrong.
Yeah.
Telling you, the Chamber of Horrors is being built right here, right now. Go ahead, open up the door.
I'm not going in there first.
Just open up the door, Missy.
I'm not opening up the door. Well, I'm ripping my manicure.
Give me a pair of gloves.
I didn't bring any gloves. You didn't do it. This is your place. You do it.
Ladies first.
I'm not going in there.
No, go ahead.
Go ahead.
Uncle Moisha!
It's dusty and dirty.
Well, what do you expect? They're building a Chamber of Horrors. It's not going to be nice and clean like a movie set where your boyfriend hangs out. Well, where is the thing anyway?
I don't see anything.
Oh, hey, look out for that rat over there, Missy.
Anybody want to buy a warehouse in Jersey, huh?
The following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, he will be accompanied by his mentor, former heavyweight champion Harley Race, and his personal bodyguard, Mr. Hughes, from Chicago, Illinois, weighing 284 pounds. He is the WCW World Heavyweight Champion, the Total Package, Lex Luger. His opponent from Charleston, South Carolina, 234 pounds, Terry Wilson.
Well, they all stand up to get a look at the World Heavyweight Champion. And, you know, a lot has gone on. We go back to the change of attitude. And we talk about what is going on now with Barry Windham and Ron Simmons, the repeated blatant attacks, wanting not only to prevent Ron Simmons from getting to Halloween Havoc, but wanting, obviously, to take out he and Barry Windham completely out of the scene. He looks like he is always, it's always bothering him to come out and either talk to me or to come out and talk to you or even to come out and wrestle. But Lex Luger is the World Heavyweight Champion. He's the man, and he really rules WCW.
Luger's arrogance is unparalleled in the sport, in WCW, and anywhere in the world. He's got the championship belt securely in his hands with Race out there, with his bodyguard out there. I mean, he's put all the players in place. And now with the challengers on his heels, Barry Windham, Ron Simmons, he's doing everything in his power to put them out.
We talked last week, and we are going to see once again and hear comments from the Z-Man. We talked last week to Luger and his entourage about the attack on the Z-Man. They denied it, of course, but you can't deny the effect of a pile driver.
Here is your winner, the undisputed World Heavyweight Champion, Total Package, Lex Luger!
Here we get another look, the patented pile driver, Lex Luger. This is why he's the World's Heavyweight Champion. Nobody does it with the devastation of Lex Luger. And now, up in the ring, my co-host Tony Schiavone in a special interview with the World's Heavyweight Champion.
Okay, Magnum, make no doubt about it, this group controls World Championship Wrestling like never before, and it was another win for the one and only World Heavyweight Champion, Lex Luger. But let's talk about last week and Barry Windham, the attack on him. And what about the attack on the Z-Man in the dressing room, which, of course, you denied last week?
Well, let me tell you something, Tony. What's been happening in World Championship Wrestling is only the beginning of a long, long, long career for the ultimate man in the world of professional wrestling today. I don't care where it is anywhere on the face of this earth. This man is unbeatable. This man is the greatest athlete ever stepped in a ring anywhere around the world.
You know, Tony, what we just saw was really pathetic. I despise it. They send me garbage. They get carried out like garbage. But it was a demonstration. It sends a clear message to any wannabe wrestler, any wannabe champion in the world today. Watch, look, open your eyes, everybody in here, everybody on national TV, and every other wrestler. There are no flaws. This is perfection. There are no weaknesses. That was a demonstration that when you step in the ring with the total package, you get hurt. When Barry Windham steps in the ring with the total package, he's gotten hurt. When Ron Simmons steps in the ring with the total package, he gets hurt. And now, what do, Harley? They form a team before Ron Simmons' match of his career, a dream of a lifetime. Halloween Havoc, I signed my name on the dotted line. I'm putting up the belt. Now, Ron Simmons, you want a tag match beforehand because you've been humiliated. Well, that's not a very smart thing to do, Ron Simmons. That's a very stupid thing to do. But that's your weakness, you see, because you got the physical qualities, you got the intestinal fortitude, but you're not very smart. You got a real bad temper. People with bad tempers make mistakes. And your mistake, Ron Simmons, is signing a tag match with myself and this one-man wrecking. Can you step up here, Mr. Hughes? This one-man wrecking machine who's been on nothing but destruction. He does whatever we tell him. So, Ron Simmons, when you step in that ring and that tag match has been signed, only one thing can happen. Either you don't make it to Halloween Havoc, or if you do, it won't be in one piece.
The world champion. Fans, more on Worldwide still to come.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, the following feature confrontation, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from Huntsville, Alabama, weighing 233 pounds, Beautiful Bobby!
We talk about athletes in WCW that are all business, and Beautiful Bobby, when he steps in the ring, you would agree, Mag, is all business.
Without a doubt, Tony.
And ladies and gentlemen, his opponent, from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico, weighing 287 pounds, Cactus Jack.
I can tell you right now, Bobby's not waiting for the ring. Here we go. This is the right thing to do against Cactus Jack. Wouldn't you agree?
When you got this dangerous a man as your opponent, you got to pull out all the stops, and Bobby Eaton is definitely going for it.
Knowing what kind of maniac he's wrestling, he put him right with a suplex right on the floor. That was right in front of the mat on the outside.
And look at Cactus Jack. He almost seems to revel in the pain.
I think you're right. Look at him. There's a kind of a pleasure look on his face. We're crying out loud, and here we go. Bobby not letting up at all. Now, Bobby is Mr. Offense. Is he really kicking it in high gear right here? Wow, what a right hand.
That's what Bobby needs to do. He's got to stay on top of his game here because Cactus Jack can be so devastating so abruptly and so quickly.
And there you see it. Took him right off his feet, and abruptly Cactus Jack is treating things now. But Bobby, relentless, right to the head. Sending Cactus Jack a reversal. Cactus Jack in, watch out. Double axe handle, Bobby goes through the ropes. And on the outside, it was last week, I interviewed Cactus Jack, and of course, Abdullah the Butcher was here with him. These two represent the biggest threat, not only to Sting, but to anyone. Wow. That one, Bobby, went right off of the mat, right to the hard concrete floor.
Cactus can dish it out, and he can obviously take it, because all of his offensive maneuvers seem to be almost as punishing to him as they are to his opponents.
Picking up Beautiful Bobby. Throat first to the top safety rail. And now Cactus Jack, who is in a fight. For the first time since we've seen him on Worldwide, he's in a fight here against Beautiful Bobby. He has been so dominant, so devastating to his opponents. Right now, he's really picking up the pace against Bobby, and Bobby's in trouble. Cactus Jack showing he can throw a punch also.
Well, he's in the first scheduled fight we've seen him with a top quality competitor. We've seen him spring out in some surprise attacks, but Bobby Eaton knew what he was getting into when he signed for this match.
A warning from Randy Anderson, the use of the clenched fist. Bobby will not stay down. That's one of his characteristics. This guy is an animal.
Tony's so punishing. I mean, these aren't your average wrestling maneuvers that come out of a textbook, that's for sure.
Cactus Jack has the arm crossed against the board. Face first. Down on Bobby. Look at him. He had that arm hooked around the face. He may have it. Well, he really didn't hook a leg, and Bobby was able to kick out of that.
I'm really not so sure that Cactus Jack is so interested in a 1-2-3 per se. He likes to dish out that punishment. He seems to really enjoy being the one in control of the pain.
I never really thought that Cactus Jack wanted to do a 1-2-3. Bobby, who still is wobbly, as you can see, knocked the taste out of his mouth with that one. Cactus Jack using that big frame behind that clothesline. Two count one more time. Bobby is out of it once again. So Cactus Jack continues his assault on beatable Bobby. This match started up the entryway. Bobby attacking Cactus Jack, and it's been going back and forth since then. And this wild man continues to come forward. Bobby continues to knock him off his feet. But look at Cactus Jack. He comes back up for more.
Cactus can take a lot of punishment. You've got to give him that, and Bobby Eaton is certainly dishing it out.
Picked him up. Atomic drop. Bobby's still on his feet, though. Cactus sends him over. And Bobby goes down to the floor. Now, this is where it's really dangerous against Cactus Jack. If you're beautiful Bobby, but of course he is still dazed, you would want to get back in the ring. To the steps, and those are metal steps, I might add, right at ringside.
I would say that Randy Anderson's definitely got his work cut out for him because this thing is about to get out of control. What's Cactus up to now?
He has peeled back the safety mats on the side. And he's going to take Bobby down.
And talk about a counter.
Can you believe what we have just seen? Incredible. A belly to back on the concrete floor. The chant for Bobby goes out. Right hand in the face. What a maneuver on the outside.
And the fact that Cactus is still on his feet is incredible.
Bobby, ready. He wants to end it right now. Abdullah the Butcher has come in. You saw the stick, the kendo stick on the back. A beautiful Bobby.
Here's your winner, Cactus Jack.
He was nailed by Abdullah the Butcher. And now they're going to dish up some punishment on Bobby. Bobby getting out of the way. Just in the nick of time. Incredible turn of events here. And what a reckless abandoned match between a wild man helped out by another wild man and, of course, beautiful Bobby. Fans, we'll have more on Worldwide in just a moment. On the program, we saw the attack of Z-Man in the dressing room, of course, right before he was ready to referee a match. And of course, Luger and his men deny having anything to do with it, but someone is behind this. Someone's been behind a lot in World Championship Wrestling.
Some very suspicious situations. We all have our ideas about who's behind these things going on, but we can't say. We don't want to libel ourselves, but somebody's going to get to the bottom of it very soon.
We're going to take you back now, fans. 1 week ago, this happened to the Z-Man. Then we have some comments from the Z-Man himself.
Well, there's Cactus. Apparently, Eric is not there. Wait a second. One of the world.
Somebody help! We need help in here.
Craig, if you can hear me in the truck, we need some help in the dressing room area. Listen, I'm going to go back there myself, see what's going on.
some help?
You know, the whole world saw feet enter a dark locker room, but I felt those feet, and it was Mr. Hughes, Harley Race, and they were sent by you, Lex Luger, to try and keep me from refereeing this match? Oh, no, you're not going to keep me from refereeing it, because the people deserve a fair outcome, and that's why I got the license, that's why I signed for this match. Lex Luger, you sent the guys to get a job done. They didn't. Too bad I'm still standing here. I'm sore. I felt the kicks. I felt the boots. Lex Luger, Mr. Hughes, Harley Race, after this match is over, it's going to be payback time because the Z-Man's coming after you, and this time look out because you've never seen this side of me. I'm going to get each and every one of you three. I promise.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from the Diamond Mine, weighing 298 pounds, the Diamond Stud. His opponent from Kansas City, weighing 237 pounds, T.C. Carter.
Diamond Stud has the attention of everybody here.
Everybody listen to me. All you little kids out there, take a good look at the Stud, because I'm what you want to be when you grow up. I'm your role model. Hey, Capetti, you know what time it is? You know what time it is? It's Stud time!
The Diamond Stud, certainly one of those successful competitors here in WCW, and a great contrast of styles. A beautiful Bobby, a great complete wrestler, the crazy animal, the Cactus Jack, and of course the sleek body and the power of the Diamond Stud. We have seen all in the last 12 or 13 minutes here.
Yeah, we have covered it all from A through Z, so to speak. The Stud is certainly impressed with himself. To call himself the role model for the children of America is a little too strong for me, though.
I don't think there are many children out there that take a look at him and say, hey, I want to be like that. Although he is a really fine-looking athlete, it's the attitude. Of course, there's no question to be successful in WCW, having power moves like he has, power slam, diamond death drop, the tremendous clothesline, is a good step in the right direction.
Well, in WCW, actions certainly speak a lot louder than words. There's a lot of people here that talk just to hear themselves talk, but the Stud can certainly back up everything he says.
T.C. Carter, flat as a pancake right now. Diamond Stud, so overwhelming in each and every match we've seen. And of course, that belly to back off the top would have been enough, but he's ready for the Diamond Death Drop. Wow!
It's his signature move.
It is all over for T.C. Carter.
Ladies and gentlemen, here's your winner, the Diamond Stud.
The Diamond Stud continues to pick up wins. And of course, he's part of the Chamber of Horrors at Halloween Havoc. And of course, no one knows what that's about yet, as we take a look at once again.
Belly the back off the top, the Stud looking very devastating here today, and then the Diamond Death Drop. This would put anybody out.
Your winner is the Diamond Stud.
Wrestling fans, the following contest, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, the godfather of World Championship Wrestling, Theodore R. Long, proudly presents from Macon, Georgia, weighing 251 pounds, Johnny B. Bag. His opponent from Sevierville, Tennessee, weighing 208 pounds, Keith Hart.
Johnny B. Bag, Keith Hart set to go as we take a look at the human orchid.
The human orchid?
The human orchid. That's what they say. And, you know, that's what they called Gorgeous George at one time, the human orchid.
great comparison to Johnny B. Badd and Gorgeous George. Of course, when he's in the ring, much like Gorgeous George was, he has the attention of everyone.
It looks like a big party, doesn't it, Tony?
It's like New Year's Eve, or it's like the troops coming home in a ticker tape parade. Tell you what, World Championship Wrestling, as we are now into the month of October, red hot. And I want to take a moment here to tell all of our great fans who are ready to join us in just about 2 months from now, at the end of November, for the Bruise Cruise, that the Bruise Cruise is set to sail on November 30th. You still have an opportunity to spend a whole week with the WCW wrestlers, be able to meet them, get autographs, see matches. It's going to be quite an event. As Johnny B. Badd says, he's a bad man. We look forward to having all of our great fans with us on the Bruise Cruise. It's a once-in-a-lifetime opportunity.
Is Johnny B. Badd going to be there?
Well, I don't think I know yet, but in the weeks to come, we'll be telling you who will be on the Bruise Cruise, I'm sure. And your chance to meet some of those great WCW superstars. Speaking of superstars, Johnny B. Badd really has become one in a short period of time. And I say this so much, great go behind, great takedown. I say this so much about Johnny B. Badd. Obvious his flamboyance is going to draw attention to itself. But it's his sheer ability that is putting him in the top 10 in WCW week after week.
Tony, without a doubt, what his actions are inside the ring are more important than the entrance and all the hype. And Johnny B. Badd is certainly a man that's going to have to be reckoned with here, because he is certainly the cream of the crop.
Tremendous move. I think that's a new move we've seen from Johnny B. Badd. He continues to pull out the new moves, so to speak. Snap suplex. Very crisp.
He can beat you up. He can talk you to death. I mean, talk about adding insult to injury.
He can wrestle you, and of course, as we all know, he can knock you flat out, where there's no tomorrow. Johnny B. Badd taking Keith Hart apart. A high knee. Tremendous footwork. Johnny B. Badd, who's cheered, who's booed, but who has always noticed. That time, he lifted Keith Hart off his feet and right to the mat.
Ladies and gentlemen, the winner of the match, Johnny B. Badd.
Johnny B. Badd with a tremendous win once again. They're going to put on the kiss, as they say, that don't miss. It certainly does not miss at all on Keith Hart. Well, another one down. Again, Mac.
I mean, innovative new moves, inverted, reverse, vertical suplex. I've never seen anything quite like that. And then poetry in motion. That left hand took him right off of his feet. He didn't even know where he was. Talk about dreamland.
He was in dreamland before that. Johnny B. Badd continues to win and turn heads in World Championship Wrestling. But next week, we have a tremendous matchup. It'll be a tag team match as we see Flying and Brian team up with former World Junior Heavyweight Champion Mike Graham against the York Foundation.
Talk about combining all the right moves. This could be a classic confrontation.
It could be a classic confrontation. It'll be with us next week, this big tag team match. Be sure to check your local listings for the time of Worldwide Wrestling. Standing by, both teams now with comments on next week's big main event.
Right here next week, Mike Graham, Flying Brian, taking on the York Foundation. Well, get ready to punch good old-fashioned butt-kicking into that computer.
I saw y'all's beginning, and I'm going to be part of your end right here next week.
Not only is the York Foundation armed with the most powerful computer known to man, but we also have one ace in the hole. When we wrestle as a tag, we sign the contract as the York Foundation. So Mike Graham and Flying Brian, you never know which combination you're going to wrestle.
It should be a great matchup next week right here on Worldwide Wrestling. We hope you'll join us at that time. And what about the world champion, Lex Luger?
Lex Luger said he was going to be dishing out some attitude adjustments, but I don't think anybody, myself included, realized just how far he would go in giving those adjustments. Certainly Ron Simmons and Barry Windham have a different outlook about Race, Hughes, and Luger, and the confrontations that are going to come up are going to be tremendous.
And Z-Man is ready to be the referee. Fans from Magnum TA, I'm Tony Schiavone. See you next week here on Worldwide Wrestling.
Now, if listed...
Sending Cactus Jack a reversal. Cactus Jack in. Watch out. Double axe handle. Bobby goes through the ropes and on the outside. It was last week I interviewed Cactus Jack, and of course, Abdul the Butcher was here with him. These two represent the biggest threat, not only to Sting, but to anyone. Wow. That one, Bobby, went right off the mat, right to the hard country floor. Hi, everyone. Tony Schiavone and Magnum TA. Welcome back to another week of Worldwide Wrestling. And you saw at the top of the program action from last week. Beautiful Bobby and Cactus Jack, indicative of the action we have each and every week right here with the superstars of World Championship Wrestling. This week, our main event. As we said last week, we'll see the former World Junior Heavyweight Champion Mike Graham and Flying Brian against the York Foundation.
What a high-flying exhibition of wrestling maneuvers that should be. The York Foundation is going to have their hands full with the veteran Mike Graham and Flying Brian Pillman.
And we'll see Gordon Solie, the Wrestling News Network, talking about the situation that developed last week between the Freebirds and the Enforcers. In addition, you'll see Larry Zbyszko of the Enforcers against Jimmy Jam Garvin.
One-on-one, this will be an interesting confrontation because we know they're tag team specialists, but what they can do when there's just one man out there will be very good.
Stunning Steve Austin defends a World TV belt against Steve of the Young Pistols. Well, right now we're ready for our first event this week on Worldwide Wrestling.
The following tag team event, it is set for one fall. Introducing first, from the WCW Special Forces, they are the United States Tag Team Champions, Firebreaker Chip, the champion, the Patriots.
They're
all in total combined weight, 442 pounds. First, from Seymour, Indiana, Rip Rogers. From Chattanooga, Tennessee, Paul Lee.
Should be a tremendous matchup as we begin things this week right here on Worldwide Wrestling. The U.S. Tag Team Champions, the Patriots. These two youngsters who have really developed a tremendous win streak right here in WCW, Mac.
And Tony, they have the momentum working in their favor. They're on a run, as you might say. The new champions feeling good, riding high, but there's a lot of men that would like to challenge them for that very coveted title.
To see two youngsters this early, as we take a look at Rip Rogers, this early in the battles to become U.S. Tag Team Champions is a tribute to their athletic ability, because let's face it, they have not been teaming together for any long period of time, but they've come out champions.
And that youthful enthusiasm is something that they've very much capitalized here in a short period of time. As you said, they don't have the most experience together, but they're so explosive, and they've overwhelmed almost everybody they've stepped in the ring with.
Rip Rogers slips in a knee, and he's a fine veteran out of Indiana, and he's giving Chip some troubles now. Chip, great upper body development, great strength. Hip toss out of the corner, and a drop kick on target sends him down with a clothesline. One thing about Chip is he's always ready to fight, right to top champion. Back and forth goes Rip Rogers. Right hand. Rogers in a lot of trouble. Now the power of Chip picks him up. And Rogers goes in. We may have a three count right here. Nick Patrick, our referee. So it's only a two. And the Patriots on fire, as they've been much throughout their career here in WCW.
Well, I know Paul Lee didn't want to be brought into the ring in such an abrupt manner, but as he was, he really can't control the tempo here because it's been all Patriots thus far.
Chip sends him in. Great agility that time as he got out of the way of Paul Lee, who moved and all the power, a chip over the top.
Tony, that should be all she wrote.
It very well could be, Mag. Communicating with his partner now, the head of special forces, top champion, his first time in. There's his spinning elbow. That was right on target. And he hooks the leg against the throat cut.
Ladies and gentlemen, here are your winners, the Patriots.
The Patriots open up the hour on Worldwide with a sensational win.
Here we see Barnbreaker Chip coming high off that top turnbuckle. Paul Lee didn't know what hit him. As I said, I think he was beaten right here, but he set him up for the icing on the cake as the big man came in with a flying reverse elbow that put Paul Lee down for an easy 1-2-3.
They are the U.S. Tag Team Champions, and right now we take you to our top 10. And now, fans, here's a look at the World Championship Wrestling Top 10 in singles competition as compiled by members of the WCW Board of Directors and its promoters for the weekend of Saturday, October 12th. Breaking in the top 10 once again this week, in the number 10 spot, former World Television Champion, Beautiful Bobby. The number 9 man, up one spot from last week, the Diamond Stud. Johnny B. Badd holds steady at number 8 this week, as does the number 7 man, Cactus Jack from Truth or Consequences, New Mexico. The number 6 man, the natural Dustin Rhodes. Remaining at number 5 this week, the World Television Champion, Stunning Steve Austin. 7'7", Elegante is at number 4. The number 3 man for the second week in a row, Barry Windham. At number 2, the All-American Ron Simmons. And the number 1 ranked contender once again this week.